A very good morning to you all, my dear students. How are you? Hoping for the best. Let's start some important questions today. We have discussed all the chapter in previous video. So, our first important question is, what is the difference between multiple cropping and modern farming methods? Multiple cropping is a process under which more than one crop is grown on a piece of land during the year. Whereas in modern farming, production is increased using HYB seeds and other inputs. And second difference is, it is a natural, multiple cropping is a natural way of maintaining the fertility of soil and increasing production, whereas modern farming is a scientific way of maintaining the fertility and of soil and increasing the production. And third point is, multiple cropping is practiced by poor farmers because it is very the cost of multiple cropping is very low, whereas modern farming is practiced by rich farmers only. Now, some other questions we have already done. Our first question is, explain four requirements for production of goods and services. Four requirements, what we need for production. We can explain the four factors of production. First is land, labor, physical capital. It is of two types, working capital and fixed capital. And last one is human capital. So we can explain properly and it can be in long questions also. Now, second question is, distinguish between fixed capital, working capital and human capital. As we have done fixed definition, we can explain their definitions and we can solve this question. Now, third question is, describe the land distribution of farmers of Palampur. It is also done by, we have done it. Landless farmers are 150 families. Small farmers, they have 240 families. They have less than 2 hectare land. And medium farmers have are 60 families and they have more than 2 hectare land. And large farmers have 10 hectare or more than 10 hectare land. Okay, we can explain it properly and it is also our long question. Now, disadvantages of green revolution, we can explain the drawbacks of high yielding varieties seeds. Okay, so these questions are already done and these are also very important question of this chapter. Now, next question, state any four features of land and factors of production. Suggest ways to sustain it. Okay, land is a natural or free gift of nature. This is first feature of land. Second is, land is a fixed factor of production. It is fixed because land is not changed after 1 year or 2 years. Land is fixed factor. Third is, land being a natural resource, it is necessary to be very careful in its use. Because if soil fertility is once lost, it takes very much time to be usable land. And next is, production from the same piece of land can be increased by using various modern techniques. We can use modern high yielding variety seeds or modern machinery to increase our production. Now we have explained features of land. Now, how can we sustain land? How can we sustain land? The first way is, farmers should use biocompost एंड इको फ्रेंडली मेथड्स इन प्लेस ऑफ यूजिंग केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स एंड पेस्टिसाइड्स. मीन्स फार्मर्स शुड नॉट यूज केमिकल ओवर यूज ऑफ केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स एंड पेस्टिसाइड. एंड सेकेंड इज मॉडर्न फार्मिंग मैथड्स नीड टू बी यूज इन सच ए वे दैट द लैंड इज सेव फ्रॉम फर्दर डैमेज. बिकॉज इन मॉडर्न फार्मिंग केमिकल्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स पेस्टिसाइड्स आर मोर यूज, सो वी हैव टू यूज इन प्रॉपर वे सो दैट लैंड इज सेव फ्रॉम फर्दर डैमेज. एंड नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इट इज़ ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, इज इट इम्पॉर्टेंट टू इंक्रीज द एरिया अंडर इरीगेशन एंड वाई? येस, इट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टू इंक्रीज द एरिया अंडर इरीगेशन. वट डू मीन बाई इरीगेशन? वाटरिंग द क्रॉप्स. सो इट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट इज़ द बेसिक इनपुट फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स. अ क्रॉप नीड वाटर टू ग्रो, सो इरीगेशन इज़ द बेसिक इनपुट फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स. सेकेंड इज मॉडर्न HYV seeds need assured irrigation. HYV seeds need more water to grow, so HYV seeds assured irrigation, need assured irrigation. And third is at that places where water is not available, where regions are dry, we can grow crops by using irrigation. And last one is arrival and departure of monsoon is also uncertain. So we need irrigation facilities. As we all know, our agriculture is dependent on monsoon. But monsoon is not certain, so we have to increase the area under irrigation. So, okay friends, that's all from my side. Our chapter is complete. We have also discussed important questions. And best of luck. Till then, goodbye and thank you.